Hello, my name is Svenja. I'm a PhD student and working on stem cell-based cancer therapies. Since it is known that mesenchymal stem cells specifically target tumors inside the body, we want to elucidate how these cells act upon tumor tissue. So I am looking at these cells and how they act on and inside of in vitro tumor cell aggregates. To image these spherical three-dimensional samples, I use light sheet technology. Our light sheet setup is based on an open microscopy project, and homemade as it is, we can flexibly adapt it to our needs. So let me show you how it works. The Open SPIM project provided us with build-up instructions and open source software for light sheet microscopy. And this is how our setup looks like. The special technique of light sheet microscopy becomes clear when comparing it to classical microscopy. In confocal microscopy, the excitation laser runs parallel to the detection axis through the whole sample. Although the detected region is very small, the illuminated area at each scanning point covers the whole sample depth. In light sheet microscopy, the excitation axis is rotated 90 degrees, so that the sample is illuminated from the side. Optics form a thin light sheet, penetrating the whole sample, but only at the focal plane. Signals are not detected point by point, but from the whole plane at once. In this way, the sample can be scanned much faster, and bleaching and phototoxicity are reduced to a minimum. Now, let's see how this looks like in practice. The sample is mounted in agarose within a special sample holder and inserted into the sample chamber. The motorized stage later moves it step by step through the focal plane. The excitation and the detection objectives are at a 90 degree angle to each other, with the sample exactly at the intersection of both axes. The laser provides the excitation light. We have expanded the original setup to a two-color microscope by adding a second laser of a different wavelength. Both laser beams are, in an alternating fashion, fed into the excitation pathway. Mirrors and lenses help the beam align and guide to and through the excitation objective. The very heart of light sheet optics, however, is the cylindrical lens. It focuses the laser beam only in one direction. Thus, a sheet of light is formed. This light sheet now penetrates the sample and excites the whole focal plane at once. The camera takes a picture through the detection objective at each set stack of the sample that is moved step by step through the light sheet. The raw data I obtain
are SET stacks through the tumor cell aggregate. One channel showing nuclear staining of every cell within the spheroid, the other showing fluorescently labeled invaded stem cells. To optimize image quality, each spheroid is scanned from 5 different angles. With the help of fiducial beads, each of these scans can be aligned and finally combined to one homogeneous image. The processing of these raw datasets requires time and computational power. We implemented macros to handle processing of whole data files automatically, feeding them to our powerful imaging server one after another. Using the finally processed data, I can then analyze the behavior of stem cells on in vitro tumor spheroids. A relevant question for therapeutic use is, for example, how far these cells invade the tumor under different conditions. To quantify this, I segment every stem cell within the spheroid and measure the invaded distances in this three-dimensional context.